where social media was an asset and a detriment.
In the meantime, we are staying on top of a developing story this morning. A local 18-year-old is shot and killed by police in Ferguson. Family members joined by protesters are demanding answers. News 4's Brittany Noble is live at Ferguson Police Headquarters, where officers have indicated they could release some more information later today. Brittany.
Well, Deanna, last night the Ferguson police chief told me that he planned to hold a news conference today. Now it's unclear if that's going to happen since the chief is waiting for confirmation from St. Louis County Police. County police are handling this investigation. Ferguson confirms they shot and killed a suspect. According to Mike Brown's mother, that suspect is her 18-year-old son. She said he was shot on Canfield Drive and left laying in the street for hours. Pictures all over social media. Brown is a 2014 graduate of Normandy High School and expected to start college.
The use of social media in the Michael Brown case was a detriment because people's actions in response to the case took away from the real issue. However, in the Eric Gardner case, people's use of social media was more constructive, which allowed for the public to focus and bring awareness to the real issue.
America's largest police force is facing a serious controversy over a video that's gone viral showing officers arresting a suspect who later died. The video is wrenching, and here's ABC's Ron Claiborne.
In the video, you can see 43-year-old Eric Garner confronted by two plainclothes officers for allegedly peddling illegal cigarettes. The officers move in to arrest him. One of them puts his forearm around Garner's neck. More police join in, pinning him to the ground as he cries out. The father of six was rushed to a local hospital where he died.
I just snatched my heart right out my chest like I'm an empty shell right now.
No justice, no peace!
The incident has stirred racial tensions in this city.
An unarmed man was subjected to a chokehold, and the result is he is no longer with us.
As he spoke, Garner's wife collapsing by his side. At issue is whether Garner was placed in a chokehold, a tactic banned by New York City police.
Using social media as an outlet in response to police brutality cases like that of Eric Garner and Michael Brown could potentially entice riots and hinder the outcome of future cases. When social media is used properly and constructively, it could evoke change. So in the future, think before you post.